David Montgomery scored the go-ahead touchdown in the final seconds, fall to 3-8.
You know, they've had a lot of adversity. You know, we've had a lot of adversity as the Chicago Bears. It's only going to make us tougher. And to me, there's a lot of things you can build off of this game right here. And really, the last 6 weeks, you can build off of. And we're going to look at it. We're going to get better from it. And then we're going to move on. 24-hour rule, we're going to move on to next week.
And that's another division matchup against the Vikings on Monday Night Football. We'll hear from Justin Fields coming up in sports. If you plan to take a nice nap after Thanksgiving dinner, you're not alone, and we now know the best time to do it.
Okay, this comes from Sleep Review. They did a survey and found that the perfect time to nap starts at exactly 2:57 p.m., right after the first football game ends. And it lasts exactly 42 minutes, Lauren. Now, if you're the one who cooks Thanksgiving dinner, you can take those naps as a compliment, because that's a sign that your guests were very happy with the meal. Most people say they're more likely to take naps during the holiday season than at any other time during the year.
If I'm the one cooking, I'm the one who should be taking the nap. This year, yeah, I think we're gonna eat like at 1 or 2 o'clock. Yeah. Buttery fast because I know it's coming right around the corner. But that to me sounds like you're just concerned about NFL games, like you're watching football.
Yeah, and that's not what the day is about.
No, it's about
Lauren's mashed potatoes.
Right. I see a potato casserole.
Yeah. Lauren is a very, very good cook.
And certain things.
Yeah.
And we'll acknowledge that. Thank you.
All right, we've got temps in the 30s in Northwest Indiana. Right now it's 38 in Valparaiso, 37 in Rensselaer, 40 in Lansing, 47 in Waukegan, 46 Midway Airport, 45 degrees at O'Hare Airport. You've got 45 in Joliet, and low 40s elsewhere. East winds are coming in right now, sustained to 15. They stay about the speed and direction today. They do gust, though, up to about 25 miles per hour. We'll keep it the same way tonight, and they ship tomorrow out of the north. Gustier, even windier for your Tuesday. It's overcast this morning. It will be today. Some of these showers off to our south arrive here mid to late morning. A lot of it breaks up as it starts to arrive here, but we do hold that chance for a little bit of rain. And again, it's more so in the north central part of the state now. Here's about 10 a.m. You can see it directly in our area. Places like Valparaiso, Lansing, Aurora, DeKalb at that point, seeing just a little bit of rain. Most of the rain, though, arrives here by your late day. So here's 4 p.m. You've got some scattered showers working in from south to north. It becomes widespread overnight. Here's midnight tonight. Some pockets of moderate rain at that time, but it gets heavier by tomorrow morning. Here's your commute tomorrow morning. This is likely a little overdone, but some pockets, likely more so pockets of heavy rain tomorrow, and then widespread across the board. That's for the morning commute. We'll get into your afternoon on Tuesday. Here's 2 o'clock. Some scattered rain. We'll keep even a scattered chance there about 5, 6 p.m. tomorrow. Today, 48, so not much warming. We're at 45 right now. Cloudy, east winds, some late-day rain showers, and again, a couple possible this morning. 41 with rain likely all night, overnight, especially from midnight beyond into the morning commute tomorrow. It's pretty widespread. Windy tomorrow as well at 44. A little more sun around here by your Wednesday afternoon at 43. Thanksgiving forecast up next. Hey, Courtney.
Hey, Morgan. If you're heading out on the roads right now, the good news is it's pretty light as far as volume goes across the roadways. This is a look at the Dan Ryan. As you approach the Jane Byrne interchange, we're not seeing much activity, really. Cars moving pretty freely through there. We also have police activity that's closing down Fullerton between Pulaski and Springfield. The CTA is rerouting number 74 buses as a result of that. So something you want to know if you're heading out the door. We had an earlier crash outbound on the Kennedy near Canfield Road that has been cleared, not causing any residual delays. So traffic is moving through that area. Looking across the map, things really do look good. We have a tiny bit of a slowdown from the Stevenson into the Dan Ryan, but that's just really minor. We see that every morning, so nothing of concern at this moment. That's a look at your traffic.
Coming up next, family and friends in Colorado remember the victims of the deadly shooting at an LGBTQ nightclub 1 year ago.
Plus, why fans of Formula One have filed a lawsuit over a race in Las Vegas this weekend.
Sub 25 years ago, it was a little daunting for me. You're always a little scared when you start a new job. I come in, and one of the first persons that I see is Mary D. She was a
in Tennessee is dead, apparently by his own hand.
Mavis Christian was found in a car yesterday morning with a gunshot wound in the head. Investigators say he was related to the victims, three women and a teenager.
He framed my mother a few times before and my sister a few times before, but we didn't think much of it. Even though we should have. He went to jail for attempted murder.
The victims have been identified as Ruby Manuel, Letitia Bobo, and Letitia's daughter, Tori. The motive is not clear. Christian had previously faced charges of aggravated assault, felony domestic violence, theft, and vandalism.
A ceremony in Colorado Springs honored the five people who were killed 1 year ago in a shooting in an LGBTQ nightclub.
This shooting, that's a call by the police. It's supposed to be out.
Right now, she would have been putting up all the Christmas trees for the foster kids. It's been very hard. We take it one day at a time.
The whole world got to feel it. You know what I'm saying? There's children out here. It's sad. It's really sad.
Politicians, residents, and LGBTQ allies gathered outside of Club Q yesterday. The club's been closed since the deadly shooting that also left 17 others injured. Its owners plan to build a permanent memorial and reopen in a new location. The shooter is serving life in prison.
Video shows a volcano destroying roads in Iceland. The town of Grindavik had to be evacuated. Rumblings causing massive crack through the town. Experts say there's a significant likelihood that an eruption will occur somewhere along the 9-mile magma tunnel. The volcano has also caused a nearby Blue Lagoon tourist attraction to shut down until at least the end of the month.
Some Formula One fans are suing the Las Vegas Grand Prix and its owner after being forced to leave the venue before the start of the second practice session. Those who bought tickets to the race's opening night saw just 9 minutes before a driver ran his Ferrari over a water valve cover. That caused the first practice to be halted and fans were told to leave the course. The second run was delayed for hours Friday morning. Race officials have since offered a $200 discount at the official gift shop, but only for those who held single night tickets on Thursday. The majority of fans have 3-day passes.
Over the weekend, SpaceX successfully launched its Starship rocket, but the test flight was short-lived. And Starship spacecraft were able to lift off and separate, but within 2 minutes, a Super Heavy booster erupted into flames over the Gulf of Mexico.